It is I, your resident amputee, bringing knowledge to you.
Hello there, my beautiful internet friends. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me here today. Today, we are going to be answering the internet's most burning questions about us strange creatures known as amputees. Now, before we dive in, I would like to ask you if you wouldn't mind giving this video a thumbs up if you like it, as it helps to get out to more people and I would appreciate it. But recently I found this site called Answer the Public, which compiles data from search engines and you can type in a word and it'll tell you what people are searching for when it comes to that. I thought this would be kind of fun and interesting to see what people are actually wondering about amputees. What in the private of their own homes are people typing about me? What are people wondering? What don't people know about amputees that they'd like to discover? So let's dive in, and I will be answering these questions as your professional amputee for the day. I love how this is structured and laid out. Let's start with when. When someone is amputee? Well, this might seem like it is an easy question to answer, and technically it is. It's when you're, you know, missing a body part. But how far does that extend? I often wondered that myself. For instance, if someone loses, you know, this much of a finger, just a small portion, are they an amputee? Or do you have to lose a certain amount of volume of body parts before you actually considered one? I'm actually kind of curious about this. Let's discover together. What is an amputee? So the definition tells us that an amputee is someone who has had a limb amputated, but that doesn't really tell me. If you lose, you know, that much of a finger, are you an amputee? I thought this was gonna be easy. Perhaps not. We have absolutely no questions under where. Where are amputees? They're everywhere. They could be anywhere, doing anything. Okay, moving on to how. Amputee, how to pronounce. There you go, you're welcome. Amputee, how does it work? Well, you know, it works if you make it work for you. It can work a lot of different ways. I'm not sure if they're referring to the actual z, you know, sawing process, which is fairly self-explanatory. Man, these questions are stumping me. Oh my god, that wasn't even intentional. Amputee stump. Anyways, moving on now. How to amputee an arm? Oh dear. I will not be answering this question on YouTube now or ever, because one should not attempt to remove their own body parts. Maybe this is a doctor, you know, doing some Googling before surgery. How do amputee arms work? This is actually something I have wondered about quite a bit, because you see videos sometimes of prosthetic arms and prosthetic hands. They're freaking incredible, but they come in all different shapes and sizes and varieties, and I'm really not sure how many of them work, as I am but a lower limb amputee myself. How does an amputee take a shower? Well, I've made a whole video about that, but as a lower limb amputee, it is a little bit more of a process than one might think it to be. You have to be really careful because bathrooms are obviously slippery. If you're in the shower and you're trying to stand up on one foot, you gotta be really, really careful. So I have a shower chair. It always makes me feel like a granny, but you know, I love grannies, so that's okay. So I sit down or I have my knee against the chair when I'm showering so I have some good balance, and then I kind of have things set out when I get out of the shower so I can very quickly and easily either use my iWalk or get into my prosthetic leg. It is really important that you plan it out. I've gone on vacations before sort of not even remembering the fact that I was an amputee or now have different requirements for traveling, especially during the first year of being an amputee, because I wasn't actually used to it, and I'd get to a hotel and be like, oh crap, this is gonna be very challenging for me to use. I was at a hotel once that was just this giant open shower, and so I'd like have to crawl on tile floors to be able to safely get in and out of it, and it was not super great. How to calculate amputee BMI, which is body mass index. I actually have looked this up myself because I was kind of curious. I was like, well, you know, body mass indexes are based on people who have all their limbs. Limbs weigh something. I think my lower leg, what was amputated, weighed about 10 pounds from what I can tell. So how do you appropriately estimate BMI? It's actually a really good question. Turns out there is a complicated mathematical formula for it, and perhaps one day I shall go through that on my channel, but today is not that day. How long for amputee to heal? Well, I think you could take this question in two different directions. You have the physical and you have the emotional and mental side of things. I think that varies for absolutely everybody, but if we're talking about the actual physical act of amputation and the physical wound, generally you can start using a lower limb prosthesis by 6-8 weeks. It's not healed then, but it's definitely far along in the process. It does take a while to heal from a major surgery like that, but it does go faster than many people think. Amputee who climbed Mount Everest. I need to know if someone has done that. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. A 69-year-old double amputee from China has 5 attempts to summit Mount Everest. Oh my god. Arunima Sinha, an Indian woman who lost her leg after she was thrown from a moving train 2 years ago, oh my god, has become the first female amputee to climb Everest. That is incredible. Wow, that's awesome. A lot of people are wondering about the amputee who killed and shot his girlfriend. I cannot answer that for you, but I'm very sorry that it happened. Are you amputee? That seems like a strange thing to be searching for in Google. Are you amputee, Google? are you? Why being an amputee is awesome. What a fantastic search term to find. I can think of quite a few reasons. You get exposed to a whole new world. You have a whole new community to connect with. You have a conversation starter 100% of the time. An evergreen icebreaker, if you will. Kids think you're very cool. I have had kids who are a little bit frightened of me because they can't figure out the leg thing, which I don't blame them for a second for, but seeing how excited kids get about robot legs is actually kind of cool. What amputee mean? Well, we addressed that at the beginning of this video and I'm still not entirely sure. Amputee, what's your excuse? This is a phrase that I have a personal, deep-seated, low-level animosity for just because I hate the whole, like, what's your excuse culture, but I totally get that that works for some people. This whole idea of what's your excuse seems to be pretty popular, and I've done pretty much whole videos on this before, but the whole argument is like, look what they can do, and they're missing a body part. What's your excuse? Why aren't you doing that thing? And my response has always been, well, maybe that person doesn't want to do that thing, or maybe they're dealing with something entirely different that is just as serious. We take physical differences that we can see in people very, very seriously, and I think downplay mental, emotional, and invisible disabilities. So to say, what's your excuse? Just because you can see I'm missing a leg has never made a lot of sense to me, but that is just my own personal soapbox and I will get off of it because I know that that does work for some people. That is motivational for some people, seeing someone who seems to have less than them do more than them, and then they wanna do the thing. Not sure if that made sense. What is amputee person? What do amputee mean? What does amputee mean? That's the only proper grammatically correct one. What is an amputee? Oh my God, there are so many. What dies amputee? I'm not sure I answered that question. Will Hardy? Oh, these must be characters. Will Sawyer amputee. Oh, he's in Skyscraper. Okay, someone suggested that I do a movie review, like the Amputee Reacts series to Skyscraper, and I'm totally gonna do that. Thank you for that suggestion. It seems to be a controversial film. I'm not sure why. I'm interested to find out. Can amputee drive car? The answer predominantly is yes. There are a ton of modifications that people have come up with that I've seen to be able to drive cars, which is incredible. For me personally, I usually just take my prosthetic leg off, which is on my right side, and I use my left leg to brake and accelerate, and it's really not that challenging. It wasn't that much of an adjustment period for me, but I have seen triple amputees driving a manual car, which is incredible to watch, but it's gonna be different for everyone. But generally speaking, yes, amputees can drive. Amputee can walk, yes. Yes, I can now, thanks to a fantastic prosthetist, a prosthetic leg that costs a fortune, and practice. Can an amputee join the military? I actually think I know the answer to this. I'll fact check myself and I'll put a big no up on screen if I am incorrect, but no, amputees cannot join the military. If someone becomes an amputee while in the military, I believe that they can stay on. Yeah, I'll fact check myself on that one, but I'm pretty sure that's the case. Can an amputee get disability? This, of course, is going to vary greatly depending on your specific life circumstances, how much your amputation affects your ability to make income, you know, how painful it is. I don't know all the requirements to get on disability, but I do know some amputees are absolutely on it and some absolutely are not. Can an amputee ride a motorcycle? For the most part, I would say yes. Again, depending on your amputation type, but I could totally drive a motorcycle. Drive? Gosh darn it, my camera battery died there. Sorry about that. Also, I thought I'd review the footage for just a moment to make sure my microphone was recording because sometimes it doesn't. And I realized that with this light, I look so shiny. Look like my face is dripping in oil. And you know what, today I'm fine with that. Can an amputee skydive? Well, in my case, yes. I was weirdly thinking about this the other day, pondering how I would land during skydiving because I think coming down that hard on your prosthetic would be painful, but probably possible. I don't see any reason why not, especially if you're skydiving with someone else. I think it's called tandem. I would like to try skydiving someday, one day. I think it'd be pretty interesting. Have you ever skydived? So I'm actually a little bit surprised that a few search terms didn't pop up on this list. Like for instance, how painful is amputation is one that I wanted to know, and people don't seem to care. People don't care about the pain. I'm just kidding, they absolutely do, but they're more interested in other things. I don't know, maybe this is just a me thing, but I was definitely interested in how much things were gonna cost, so I'm surprised that, you know, how expensive are amputee prosthetics or something like that isn't on here. Oh, but maybe I should do a prosthesis one next. That would be an interesting one to cover. Let me know if you'd like to see that. Now that we've reached the end of this video, I will give the quick disclaimer that of course I'm answering these questions just for me and I might be ignorant to something. So if I said the wrong thing, I do apologize and I welcome you to correct me in the comment section. I think everyone's answers to these questions are gonna vary. Being an amputee means something unique to every single person who is an amputee. And I think learning about and sharing those experiences is really important. So let me know if you'd like to see another one of these types of videos. I think that Answer the Public is a pretty cool site. It's interesting to see what people are fascinated by, interested in, and typing into Google. So let me know what you think down below. And I really appreciate you spending a few minutes out of your day here with me today. You could be anywhere in the world doing anything, and you chose to hang out with me and my lazy cats for a few minutes, and I really appreciate that. A huge thank you goes to all my patrons over on Patreon. I really, really cannot thank you guys enough for your support and for all you do for me. Thank you. I love you guys. I'm thinking about you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys.
Well, hello, luxury cats. I wanted to show you guys these kitties real quick if you hadn't seen them before. This is Lewis Parker Jr. Yes, that is his full name. And this is our little Cakes. She actually used to be called Lady, but then she was just such a little Cakes that we had to change her name, and they deeply love each other. Say bye, kitty. Hand her from the sky.